Welcome back. My experiment's not going terribly well so far. I'm 0-2 with Blue Red Delver. I wouldn't necessarily say that the deck has been playing out poorly in these games, but I have not been the winner of either match. Maybe this time. I like this hand a lot. Gonna lead with turn one Delver, I guess, off of the Steam Vents. And then, yeah, we'll take it from there. Alright, so Wooded Foothills goes for Steam Vents. Play the Delver. Hope to get a lucky flip on turn two. And then, assuming my opponent doesn't play a one-drop creature, I probably go crack a fetch land, Serum Visions. Oh, I'm up against Tron again. Wow. All right, come on, flip. Come on, flip. This is a big one. See, the thing with Delver is it's just not that good in Modern. You don't have Brainstorm. The most you're going to have really is, like, 25 to 28 instants and sorceries, which means you're just, I mean, it's just a coin flip, or it's worse than coin flip if you're gonna transform the Delver. Sometimes you can't attack into ground creatures if you don't transform. It's just not the same card that it is in Legacy, but this game it is. So I just raw dog the turn two flip, which is great. So what I want to do here, I think the move is going to be crack for an island, pay life to probe, and then Serum Visions. Alright, so that's going to be a turn 3 Karn. I should be prepared for that. Because turn 2, play Tower, make green mana Sylvan Scrying. So I got to unload damage fast here. Alright, well, that the decision is the same as it was a second ago. Perfect, that's great. So now I'm going to play my Swift Spear. I'm going to probe again. Now I'm going to Serum. Vapor Snag looks bad here, although, yeah, I think Vapor Snag is bad here. I'm just going to top the spike. Yeah, just gonna. I'm only gonna get to draw one of these two cards anyway, because I get to because I'm cracking a fetch land next turn. But anyway, six damage on turn two from creatures is pretty good, and then I've got, let's see, 10 coming next turn if my opponent doesn't have a strong play. And then Oblivion Stone can't be activated until turn four. The Karn can only answer one creature. I think I'm in really good shape to win this game. Sure. So Wooded Foothills grabs Mountain. Swift Spear. Lava Spike. Take 10. And if my opponent's best play is to Karn the Delver, I can just Searing Blaze my own creature for one. It's an unorthodox play, but it'll get the job done here because of prowess. I just have to be careful not to play a land beforehand. Hooray, I beat turn 3 Karn. Funny part is that in all likelihood I would have lost that game if I'd been on the draw. If I'd lost the die roll. So last time I had decided that I liked Spell Pierce. Oh no, Dispel is terrible, but I did not like Spell Snare. And then Young Pyromancer is kind of crummy. Searing Blaze is kind of crummy. Vapor Snag, I boarded out last time against Tron, but I think maybe I should keep all three in this time. It's really important against Wyrmcoil Engine. I like all the burn, I like all the creatures, I like all the cards that can help me find Blood Moon. This looks fine. Perfect. Turn one creature. Both colors of mana. Definite keep. Temple Garden. That's unusual. Wonder if that means I'm gonna have to worry about something like timely reinforcements. Well, it's very possible I might need access to double blue next turn, so I'm gonna go ahead and crack for a Steam Vents. Timely reinforcements is on my radar a little bit here, so it's not even clear whether damaging myself is good or bad. Yep, sure enough, there's timely reinforcements. So, two pieces of Tron, Sylvan Scrying, Timely, Wyrmcoil. So, I'm looking at a turn three Timely, turn four Wyrmcoil. It's gonna be tough. I gotta deal a lot of damage to myself to keep up with that. I do have Vapor Snag for Wyrmcoil, so it's not hopeless. And now I feel validated in getting my dual land because both I saw the Timely Reinforcements and I drew a second blue spell that I'm gonna wanna cast. Okay, let's grab yet another Steam Vents. Serum Vision. Feels like I want the Lava Spike on the top and the land on the bottom. Swing for two. My opponent can get some tokens, but cannot gain the three life just yet. Or the six life, I should say. Sure. That's going to brick wall the Swift Spear. But no harm done, really. I guess I'll Thought Scour myself. Interesting. Well, let's get yet another Steam Vents. Thought Scour myself again. I drew a Swift Spear, but now that can be double blocked. So Ancient Stirring's not that scary here. I don't really suspect my opponent is going to find anything better to play than Wyrmcoil Engine. Then on my turn, I can go Swift Spear, Vapor Snag. Spellskite complicates things. Swift Spear, snag the Worm Coil Engine, attack. This will force a couple chump blocks. But I'm in a bit of trouble here because my opponent's going to play Wyrmcoil and Spellskite this turn with what I have access to. I mean, I'm not going to be able to attack with Swift Spear. I can get my opponent down to 4 with the Delver and 1 with the Lava Spike, but I do have to draw something. Yep, resolves. I think I need to get some remand somewhere in the main deck or the sideboard to help with matchup like this. Now, in my upkeep, I'll fetch. All I can get now is Island. And I'm looking to draw. I guess any burn spell will do the trick. That's not one of them. Whew, Path to Exile. All right. Looks like I was in worse shape than I even realized. I guess I just take the hit from the Worm Coil Engine. And I need to flip the Delver off a Serum Vision, then find Bedlam Reveler into some nice stuff. Oh, this is just going to kill me with the Lightning Bolt ability. I haven't cast a Bedlam Reveler this whole tournament so far. Alright, so now I've seen Timely Reinforcements and Path to Exile. Does that change my strategy at all? Maybe it makes Forked Bolt appealing? Though I don't have that many creatures that attack on the ground. I guess I have 6 Swift, or 7, the Bedlam Revelers and the Swift Spears. Forked Bolt's probably good enough. And cut either like a Rift Bolt or a Thought Scour. I guess Rift Bolt's the worst. Oh man, I can't play a burn deck and lose to Tron twice. That would just be such a failure. Okay, I'm on the play for game 3. Excellent hand, I love it. Yeah, I guess just Steam Vents Delver. And I can afford to wait on the probe. Possible I want to actually just Scalding Tarn for a Steam Vents. The thing is, if I find Blood Moon, I might want to get an Island. Come on, flip. Island. Alright. So now I grab a Steam Vents. I think I'll save the probe. I'll Serum Vision first. Looks like bottom and top. Forkbolt, not the most exciting card in the world, but it will flip my two Delvers, which is what I'm in the market for right now. I'm doing a good job keeping my own life total as low as possible for the purposes of timely reinforcements. We're going to look at turn three Tron. So my hope, I guess, is to probe into a counterspell. And I'm going to probe for life. Again, the timely reinforcements issue. Tower, Ghost Quarter, Thicket, Path, Spellskite, Thragtusk. So it's actually not that bad a spot for me. My opponent can't really cast anything next turn off the Urza's Tower, so he or she might instead go Razor Verge Thicket, Spellskite, and Path a Delver. And then next turn be able to play Thragtusk. A few turns from now, play Ulamog. I mean, it's going to be tough. Thragtusk resolving is just such a beating. But I'm not going to give up yet. Let's see what I draw off the probe. Vapor Snag. Decent start. So if I play it untapped, it plays around my opponent drawing timely reinforcements exactly this turn. But there could be a scenario where I end up racing the Thragtusk and the Beast, so I'm going to play it tapped, actually. So, sure enough, Razor Verge Thicket. Oh, what a beating. My opponent actually drew timely reinforcements that turn if I played the Spellskite untapped. Man. But it's not that bad because it means the Delver's not getting pathed this turn. Alright, so how far away am I from playing Bedlam Reveler? So I actually should have considered Vapor Snagging end of turn just in case I wanted to play the Reveler. Yeah, I should have Vapor Snagged into turn. Just didn't think carefully enough about it. So it's going to be the fourth. The fourth instant or sorcery in my graveyard. Probe will be the fifth. Vapor Snag will be the sixth. So I could cast Bedlam Reveler this turn, but that would involve discarding some of this stuff. I think instead I prefer that I'll just top the Serum Visions, top both the cards actually, and cast them this turn. So go like top, top. Now I probe. So again, next turn's gonna be Spellskite Thragtusk, I guess. And there's no rush on getting the Bedlam Reveler into play because I'm not gonna be able to attack with it. Blood Moon's nice here. I guess I just top both. Next turn I play Blood Moon. The following turn I can play Reveler plus Delver. No, maybe I bottom the Delver. Top the Blood Moon, bottom the Delver. Opponent's going down to 11 here. I'm gonna have to, I guess, Vapor Snag. I guess I can Vapor Snag the Thragtusk. Well, that's not a great play. But sure, it's going to resolve. I can go Bolt the Thragtusk, Vapor Snag the token. And keep in mind, I'm going to play Blood Moon next turn. Sure. And I'm going to not search, because I would rather draw the Blood Moon. End of turn, Bolt, Thragtusk, Vapor Snag, Beast. I just can't really race a 5-power ground creature here when my opponent's at such a high life total. Now I swing. I cast Blood Moon. Hopefully it should slow my opponent down a bit. Remember, my opponent's hand is Ghost Quarter, Ulamog, Spellskite. I can't remember if I know the last card or not. Forest. Ghost Quarter, Ulamog, Oblivion Stone. Alright, finally, it's Bedlam Reveler's time to shine. I don't care about the redundant Blood Moon, it's eventually probably going to die to Oblivion Stone anyway. Okay, pretty solid. At this point, maybe am I probing for life? So, Oblivion Stone, Ulamog, Ghost Quarter. Or sorry, probing for mana. It's going to be a close game. Problem is that Oblivion Stone is going to go off, and then Ulamog is going to come down the next turn. Yeah. Well, this actually could allow me to win by Vapor Snagging the Spellskite. If I Vapor Snag the Spellskite, I attack my opponent down to 1. And then my opponent can go Oblivion Stone, replay Spellskite, but no blue mana means that's not even that big of a threat. Also, a play that I didn't really thoroughly consider there. I don't think it would have been good here, but you can always Vapor Snag your own Bedlam Reveler. That's a big part of the construction of this deck, having three each of those cards. Oh no. All right. Well, a 3 damage burn spell still does it, still does the trick. Yes, I got there. Does it matter what order I do things in? I guess I attack first. Wow, close match. All right. So I get on the board with Blue Red Delver here.